Hey everybody, I just wanted to share a quick little electrical tip that I've done to a couple of my cars. I've done it to the General, I've done it to Smurf, I've done a patina, and I've even done it to a couple Chevys that I've had. And this works for all classic cars. What you want to do is you want to eliminate the amperage load through the headlight switch, because the headlight switches in these classic cars really was never intended to handle the amperage load. It's just the wires or the electrical connectors, they're not that strong. And then when they start getting resistance, they heat up and then they melt the plugs. And then the headlights, anytime you get a weak contact, that gets warm. I mean, the headlight switch in the General, before I converted this to the relays, I mean, I'd stick my hand up there and I'd be because the headlights were a little flickery sometimes. I'd stick my hand up there and the headlight switch was warm, which that means there's amperage going through there and there's resistance. So best thing to do is you can put a new headlight switch in it, but it still isn't fixing the issue. You still have way too much amperage flowing through a switch. What I have done is you put two relays in here. These two relays, one handles the load from the headlights and one handles the load from the high beams. Make sure I'm getting the relays in the picture. There we go. So basically all I did was cut the two wires, one for the high beam, one for the headlights, and one end of it goes to the relay. The other end of it is what comes out of the relay. So the end that goes to the relay is what turns the relay on, and what powers the relay is just, you can tap into battery power or whatever. I just have a little accessory terminal here that I use for the fan, because this is a really heavy gauge fan. It's out of a Mercedes and it keeps this sucker cool. I mean, it's got 8-gauge wire going to the fan. Anyway, I have a little fuse here that is what runs the relays. It doesn't run the relay. This is just the amperage that's run through the relay. So yeah, it comes off here, goes over. Like, and this car isn't super clean. Like, I didn't bother making the wiring super tidy. This car is pretty much how I got it wiring wise. That mess on the firewall there, the duct tape on the firewall, I did that because I'm stylish like that. Didn't want all that cold, negative temperature North Dakota air going through the firewall. But, so that wire comes down, comes up, and so that is my battery power that is functioning these two relays. And the wires that come from the headlight switch, all they do is turn the relays on and off. So when I turn the headlights on, this relay activates. When I flip to high beams, then both relays activate. That way, those relays are handling all the amperage load that the headlights are requiring. So that way it takes all the stress off the headlight switch and the wiring. You got all that amperage flows through the bulkhead on the firewall, and it has to go through the headlight switch and through multiple connectors and then back out and then through another plug on the inner fender. So there's a lot of connections, a lot of splices, and then the headlight switch itself. This way, actually the headlights will probably be brighter because there's less resistance. Every time you have a connector, there's going to be resistance. So, and I have lost my headlights multiple times. I had a 6.7 El Camino I almost wrecked. I was driving through the mountains at night and the headlights just poof, went out. So I just kept the steering wheel up in the corner I was in, slammed on the brakes, and then after a little bit, when the contacts cooled off and the headlight switch, they came back on. So, strong believer in trying to take any load off the weak electrical system that these old cars already have. So yeah, that's pretty much it. Put relays on the headlights.